Okay, welcome back. So we are doing the next question for data annotation again. As you can see, the question says, study of following graph carefully in two questions. So these are distribution of candidates who are enrolled in MBA and examine the candidates who passed in the exam. So these are the candidates who enrolled in the exam. These are Next is the question says, question 1 from the table says, what percentage of candidates passed the exam from institution T out of the total number of candidates enrolled from the same institute? So they are saying the what number of candidates from institute T passed exam out of total number of candidates who enrolled in T. Because the number of pass and number of enrolled is different, the data is given to us in percentage. We have to separately calculate the percentage number for this and then this. So we'll just put the number of candidates who pass exam in T institute is 5700 total number of into the percentage, so 9% passed out of this, so this will be 5700 divided by, you can multiply by 9 into 100. So next is expected the number of students, which is 486, and then same for here, which is 8550 into 8 by 100, which will be 8550 into 8 by 100, 684. So we need to find the percentage. For that, we can just do this 486. Which is the number of candidates who passed out of the total candidate who enrolled was 684 into 100. This will give us the percentage of candidates in this ratio. So 486 divided by 684. Yeah. So this is, wait, something wrong. 486 divided by 684. 71.05%, which is none of the option, so I must get it something wrong. Let's just calculate again. The total number are 5700, right? And the candidate who passed were 2.09, which is 513. So I multiplied the wrong. 5729 is 513, not 486. So this is wrong. It's 513. So it'll be 513, and the 513 divided by 684 is 0.75, which is one of the option we are getting. So this is the answer. None of this. Let's look at the next question.
So we'll just test our intuition with this institution in this question. Yeah, you had it right. Intuition with this institution. It's our institution, so we'll just have to find the highest percentage of candidate passed to the candidate enrolled. So the ratio we need to find is candidate passed divided by candidate enrolled. So as you can see, we have only four options, which is Q, R, V and T. So we don't need to check any of this at all. So just check for four and we'll go on. Let's look at the percentage gap in this institution. Look for the biggest gap for brute force technique. As you have seen, we defined in D and the ratio in the last question, and the percentage was 70%. So we need to find more, otherwise D will be the answer. Let's just look at the R for the first. For R, it will be 10% of it. 8550 into 10% will be 855. And next is 13% of 5700. So 5700 into 0.13. If you didn't understand this, it is as simple as 13/100. You can rewrite it as this. So this will be 5700 into 0.13, which is 741. So 741 by 855 is 86.66. So we can show that T is not the answer. Next is R. R has the highest till now, which is 86.66. Percentage, highest percentage till now. We have to calculate for Q and V yet. So just calculate for Q, which is 8550 into 0.15, and then 5700 into 0.17. 8550 into 0.15. Is 1282.5. So as you can see, the data is getting in 0.5. Students can't be enrolled in 0.5, so there is a mistake in this question about data. You have to study the question, so let us do the question for the sake of doing it. 5700 into 0.17, which is 969. Divided by 1282.5 is 75.55. So Q is not the option because we have highest is R. The only option assuming is V. Let us check for that. I'll check that for this step. 8550 into 0.12, which is 1026. I'll just write here. 1026 and another one is 5700 into 0.15, which is 855 divided by 1026 is 83.60. We are close but not highest or maximum, so V is also not an option. The only option remaining is R. R is the highest percentage, is 86.66. This was all. Did find the highest percentage question. Let's look at the next question.